श्लोक 18 अथाख्या ही हरे धीमनना तारकथा शुभा लीला विद्यता स्वैरम ईश्वरस्य आत्ममया। ट्रांसलेशन। ओ वाइस सूत, प्लीज नैरेट टू अस द ट्रांसेंडेंटल पास्ट टाइम्स ऑफ द सुप्रीम गॉड हेड्स मल्टी इनकारनेशंस सच ऑस्पेशियस एडवेंचर्स एंड पास्ट टाइम्स ऑफ लॉर्ड आर परफॉर्म बाय हिज इंटरनल पावर्स। पर्पट। फॉर द क्रिएशन मेंटेनेंस एंड डिस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ द मटेरियल वर्ल्ड्स द सुप्रीम लॉर्ड पर्सनैलिटी ऑफ गॉड हेड हिमसेल्फ appears in many thousands of forms of incarnations and the specific adventures found in those transcendental forms are all auspicious. Both those who are present during such activities and those who hear the transcendental narrations of such activities are benefited. Shlok 19. Vayam tuna vitrupyanam uttam shlok vikrame यशृण्वताम रसज्ञानाम स्वादु स्वादु पदे पदे। ट्रांसलेशन। वी नेवर टायर ऑफ हियरिंग द ट्रांसेंडेंटल पास्ट टाइम्स ऑफ द पर्सनैलिटी ऑफ गॉड हेड हु इज ग्लोरिफाइड बाय हिम्स एंड प्रेयर्स। दोज हु एंजॉय एसोसिएशन विद हिम रेलिश हियरिंग ऑफ हिज पास्ट टाइम्स एट वेरी मोमेंट। Purport. There is a great difference between mundane stories, fiction or history and the transcendental pastimes of the Lord. The histories of the whole universe contain references to the pastimes of the incarnations of the Lord. The Ramayana, Mahabharata and the Puranas are histories of bygone ages recorded in connection with the pastimes of the incarnations of the Lord and therefore remain fresh even after repeated readings. For example, anyone may read Bhagavad Gita or the Srimad Bhagavatam repeatedly throughout his whole life and yet find in them new light of information. Mundane news is static, whereas transcendental news is dynamic in as much as the spirit is dynamic and matter is static. Those who have developed a taste for understanding the transcendental subject matter are never tired of hearing such narrations. One is quickly satiated by mundane activities, but no one is satiated by transcendental or devotional activities. Uttam Shloka indicates that literature which is not meant for nations, mundane literature, is in the mode of darkness or ignorance, whereas transcendental literature is quite different. Transcendental literature is above the mode of darkness and its light becomes more luminous with progressive reading and realization of the transcendental subject matter. The so-called liberated persons are never satisfied by the repetition of the words Aham Brahmasmi. Such artificial realization of Brahman becomes hackneyed, and so to relish real pleasure they turn to the narrations of the Srimad Bhagavatam. Those who are not so fortunate turn to altruism and worldly philanthropy. This means the Mayavada philosophy is mundane, whereas the philosophy of Bhagavad Gita and Srimad Bhagavatam is transcendental. Shlok 20. Krutavan kila karmani saharamein keshavaha अतिमर्त्यानि भगवान गुड़ाहा कपटमानुषहा। ट्रांसलेशन। लॉर्ड श्री कृष्णा द पर्सनैलिटी ऑफ गॉड हेड एंड बलराम पेड लाइक ह्यूमन बीइंग्स एंड सो मास दे परफॉर्म मेनी सुपर ह्यूमन एक्ट्स। पर्पट। द डॉक्ट्रिन्स ऑफ एंथ्रोपोमोफिज्म or that of zoomorphism are never applicable to Sri Krishna or the personality of Godhead. The theory that a man becomes God by dint of penance and austerities is very much rampant nowadays, especially in India, since Lord Ram, Lord Krishna and Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu were dedicated by the sages and sons to be the personality of Godhead, as indicated in revealed scriptures. Many unscrupulous men have created their own incarnations. This process of concocting an incarnation of God has become an ordinary business, especially in Bengal. Any popular personality with a few traits of mystic powers will display some feat of jugglery and easily become an incarnation of Godhead by popular vote. Lord Sri Krishna was not that type of incarnation. He was actually the personality of Godhead from the very beginning of his appearance. He appeared before his so-called mother as four-armed Vishnu. Then, at the request of the mother, he became like a human child and at once left her for another devotee at Gokul, where he was accepted as the son of Nanda Maharaj and Yashoda Mata. Similarly, Sri Baladev, the counterpart of Lord Sri Krishna, was also considered a human child born of another wife of Sri Vasudeva. In Bhagavad Gita, the Lord says that his birth and deeds are transcendental, and that anyone who is so fortunate as to know the transcendental nature of his birth and deeds will at once become liberated and eligible to return to the kingdom of God. So, knowledge of the transcendental nature of the birth and deeds of Lord Sri Krishna is sufficient for liberation. In the Bhagavatam, the transcendental nature of the Lord is described in 9 cantos, and in the 10th canto, his specific pastimes are taken up. All this becomes known as one's reading of this literature progresses. It is important to note here, however, that the Lord exhibited his divinity even from the lap of his mother, that his deeds are all superhuman. He lifted Govardhan Hill at the age of 6, and that all these acts definitely prove him to be actually the Supreme Personality of Godhead. And due to his mystic covering, he was always accepted as an ordinary human child by his so-called father and mother and other relatives. Whenever some Herculean task was performed by him, the father and mother took it otherwise, and they remained satisfied with unflinching filial love for their son. As such, the sages of Naimisharanya describe him as apparently resembling a human being, but actually he is the Supreme Almighty Personality of Godhead. Shlok 21. Kalima Gatama Jnaya Kshetre Asmin Vaishnave Vayam Asina Dirghasatren Kathayam Sakshana Harehe. Translation. Knowing well that the age of Kali has already begun, we are assembled here in this holy place to hear at great length the transcendental message of God and in this way perform sacrifice. Purport. This age of Kali is not at all suitable for self-realization, as was Satyayuga, the golden age, or Trita or Dwapar Yugas, the silver and copper ages. For self-realization, the people in Satyayuga, living a lifetime of 100,000 years, were able to perform prolonged meditation. And in Treta Yuga, when the duration of life was 10,000 years, self-realization was attained by performance of great sacrifice. And in the Dwapar Yuga, when the duration of life was for 1,000 years, Self-realization was attained by worshipping the Lord, but in the Kali Yuga, the maximum duration of life being 100 years only, and that combined with various difficulties, the process of self-realization is recommended by hearing and chanting of the holy name, fame and pastimes of the Lord. The sages of Naimisharanya began this process for the devotees of the Lord, so they prepared themselves to hear the pastimes of the Lord over a period of 1,000 years. By the example of these sages, one should learn that regular hearing and recitation of the Bhagavatam is the only way for self-realization. Other attempts are simply a waste of time, for they do not give any tangible results. Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu preached this system of Bhagavatam Dharma, and he recommended that all those who were born in India should take the responsibility of broadcasting the messages of Lord Sri Krishna, primarily the message of Bhagavad Gita. And when one is well established in the teachings of Bhagavad Gita, he can take up the study of Srimad Bhagavatam for further enlightenment in self-realization. Shlok 22. Tvam naha sandar sito dhatra dustaram nistiti hishartha tam kalim satvaharam pusam karnadhar ivarnavam. Translation. We think that we have met your grace by the will of providence, and thus we accept you as captain of the ship for those who desire to cross the dangerous ocean of Kali, which destroys all the good qualities of a human being. Purport. The age of Kali is very dangerous for the human being. Human life is simply meant for self-realization, but due to this dangerous age, men have completely forgotten the aim of life. In this age, the lifespan will gradually decrease. People will gradually lose their memory, finer sentiments, strength and better qualities. A list of the anomalies for this age is given in the 12th canto of this work. And so this age is very difficult for those who want to utilize this life for self-realization. The people are so busy with sense gratification that they completely forget about self-realization. Out of madness, they frankly say that there is no need for self-realization because they do not realize that this brief life is but a moment on our great journey towards self-realization. The whole system of education is geared to sense gratification, and if a learned man thinks it over, he sees that the children of this age are being intentionally sent to the slaughterhouses of so-called education. Learned men therefore must be cautious of this dangerous age, and if they at all want to cross over the dangerous ocean of Kali, they must follow the footsteps of the sages of Naimisharanya and accept Sri Suta Goswami or his bona fide representative as the captain of the ship. The ship is the message of Lord Sri Krishna in the shape of Bhagavad Gita or the Srimad Bhagavatam. Shlok 23. Bruhi Yogeshware Krishne Brahmane Dharma Varmani Swam Kashtam Adhunopate Dharmahakam Sharanam Gataha. Translation. Now that Sri Krishna, the Absolute Truth, the Master of all mystic powers, has departed for his own abode, please tell us by whom religious principles are presently protected. Purport. Essentially, religion is the prescribed course enunciated by the personality of Godhead himself whenever there is gross misuse or neglect of the principles of religion. The Supreme Lord appears himself to restore religious principles. This is stated in Bhagavad Gita. Here the sages of Naimisharanya are inquiring about these principles. The reply to this question is given later. The Srimad Bhagavatam is the transcendental sound representation of the personality of Godhead, and thus it is the full representation of transcendental knowledge and religious principles. Thus end the Bhakti Vedanta purports of the first canto, first chapter of Srimad Bhagavatam, entitled Questions by the Sages.